With each passing hour, my conviction that this whole charade of GOP lawmakers, Senate Majority Leader of Michigan, and the Speaker of the House meeting Donald Trump at the White House is a publicity stunt. I'll make the case here, and you can draw your own conclusions. First and foremost, only Michigan has a state board of canvassers, which has two Republican members and two Democratic members. The board certifies the election results, and the electors are assigned to the winner of the popular vote. The counties in Michigan have already certified their results. Now, you don't have a legal standing to say the certification at the local county level is wrong. At best, you can request for an audit and delay the certification. Even if that were to happen, you will set a date and get that signed off. Now, assuming the GOP canvassers still refuse, the Democrats will go to the court, argue that the counties have certified an irreversible position, tell the court the audit is over, and out-of-balance precincts are a common problem that occurs during the elections, produce evidence of past certifications where out-of-balance precincts were certified. The argument will clearly be these out-of-balance precincts have no bearing on the result and GOP members are stalling for time. Either the court will order the members to do their job or it might punt the authority to the governor. The Michigan governor has the authority to appoint interim members to the Board of Canvassers if she chooses to do so. So the statewide Board of Canvassers in Michigan do not have a legal standing to not certify the results, not when Wayne County GOP members openly admitted that the out-of-balance precincts will not change the result and they only wanted an audit. So, if I were to advise the Michigan governor, I will suggest her to call the GOP bluff, let them deadlock at the statewide certification meeting and take them to court and get it certified. Now, second, the GOP legislature does not have the grounds to change the law of appointing electors after the election is over. If they wanted, they could have changed the law before the election, but not after. But just for the sake of it, let us assume the Michigan GOP gets together and appoints a list of pro-Trump electors and sends them to the Electoral College meeting. The governor will certainly send her list of electors signed by her, and the GOP would have sent one. In case of a difference, the law says the Congress should accept the governor's list. Or the Congress, the Speaker in particular, can throw the entire state out of the calculation and Biden still has the numbers. Okay, so this is all far-fetched and I don't think it is going to happen. I just wanted to give you the procedures that will be followed in both those scenarios. So Trump only has access to 232 electors. Even if Michigan flips for him, it will only get him to 248. A good 22 miles away from 270. Trump has zero chance to play in Nevada without a court order because of the Democratic legislature. Now, out of this group, Arizona, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin, where will he get his 22 votes? He will get nothing out of this group. Wisconsin election chief Megan Wolf is the one who is responsible to sign off on the election. The legislature has no role to play in Wisconsin, and the Secretary of State is responsible for certifying the results in all the other three states, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and Arizona. Both Pennsylvania and Arizona have a Secretary of State from the Democratic Party, and they will sign off on the elections. So why the heck did Trump invite Michigan lawmakers to the White House? The only reason I have is he invited them in the afternoon. Expect some mind-numbing announcement sometime today afternoon that creates just enough hysteria to drown out the news that Georgia Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger has certified the results. Once the GA secretary signs off on the results, it will move to the governor's desk. And as per the law, he will sign off on that by 5 p.m. Saturday, I believe. After watching Fox News, I'm quite confident that both men will certify the results and send Biden electors to Congress without a hitch. Trump wants to raise as much money from his followers before the curtains come down on his efforts to overturn the results. The GA certification will blow a big hole into the illusion that his campaign has built in the last few weeks. The White House meeting gives him enough cover to continue the illusion for some more time. Thanks for watching. If you like the content, please subscribe and help the channel grow. Otherwise, the channel is going to stay hidden under the pile of social media misinformation. Thank you.